Oh, they're shooting the vehicle. Should we just run for it? Remove unnecessary items. Tweeting one. Oh, no kidding. Oh, because now we picked up. Now we have all our other stuff. Got it. Well, this isn't as good. Sorry, and this breaks up the action, but. Disassemble. Disassemble. What else? That's what we're using. Too bad we don't have a vendor in this car, too. I mean, it does everything else. No wacky. This one's not as good. Alright, we're good.
Client feedback noted.
How's our ride looking?
Tip top. Though, alas, we are being pursued.
Oh my god!
Please remain calm.
Calm!
Roadblock ahead.
Brace for impact. Whoa!
A hostile enemy aircraft has a
lock-on. Oh my Leave it to god, me. What? Where's the aircraft?
Why can't they just give up?
I'm using a pistol though. Got one. Oh my god, I can't even. You're welcome. You're pale. You kind of look like a corpse right now.
You're right as a ghost, Jack.
See? I told you we'd make it.
I'm getting kind of worried about you.
My medical diagnostics indicate that Mr. Wells's condition is critical.
Oh no. So hurry up.
Then step on it!
I am doing what I can.
Does a Ripper Doc help with that?
You gotta hold tight, Jackie, you hear me?
Oh my god.
Of course.
I suggest you try to keep Mr. Wells conscious.
Okay. Think about Misty, you'll see her soon.
It's gonna be alright. You'll see Misty, your mom, everyone you love. Jackie, don't close your eyes.
Misty. Oh, she knew. She always knew.
Yeah, she knows.
Biochip. Hold on to it. For me.
Jackie, you're not going anywhere. This biochip. Ugh.
Mr. Wells has passed. Where shall I take his remains?
Are you seriously asking me that question?
The Excelsior package provides for the disposal of passenger remains free of charge. I merely require a destination.
Yeah, the rain definitely suits the moment. Damn it, take him home to his family.
He'd want to be with his family.
Mr. Wells's closest blood relative is Guadalupe Alejandra Wells, proprietress of the El Coyote Coho Bar. I will make sure to deliver him safely. Mr. DeShawn awaits you in room number 204.
See you in the major leagues, Jackie.
See you in the major leagues, Jack.
Secure the area. Many ways to skin a cat. Saburo Arasaka murdered by his own son. And in front of our goddamn eyes. Know what, V? Forget what I said about getting into the afterlife. First, we need to find a way to get the hell out of this, leap storm before Arasaka spec ops jump down our throats. So that's how it ends, at least for me. In the backseat of a limo with hot corporate lead wedged in my gut. You know, all things considered, that ain't a half-bad way for a Wells to go. Most sons of Haywood tap out without all those fireworks. What can I say? Night City's chewed up names way bigger than mine before. Not you, though. You still got work to do. Cut a fat deal, with Dex in my honor. And don't piss it all away in vain, or I'll be rolling in my grave until I hit the East Coast. I won't give you a minute of goddamn peace, chica. This is the last favor we owe ourselves. Many ways to skin a cat. Go to the Revere Courier Services facility. Import it in the form of jackets, which is then distributed to Underground Ripper Dock, that use them for their implants, which are then sold at competitive prices. Quite a supply chain, right? My client tracked down the shipment but can't take care of it on your own. You're her replacement. Just remember that the RCS can't roll until it validates the driver's identity. Oh, and did I mention that the RCS warehouse is controlled by the Tiger Claws? No? Well, I'm telling you now. They use it for laundering cash, so don't be surprised to see them prowling around. Be careful, and good luck. Well, we just got that gig. That's through there, and then this. Is right there. Broken down car. Where's, like, my stuff? I can't use guns. They're not coming out. I mean, I can't bring them out. Oh, so it's 850 meters. Okay, never mind. Let's say something about securing the area. Get to room 204. Lat-Am Wars. Yeah, I'll read this. As a direct result of the armed conflicts on U.S. soil from early 1990s until the early 2000s, Latin America, comprising South and Central America, remodeled itself into a strong federation of independent nations, bound through mutual aid and cooperation. The U.S.'s military presence was forced from Latin American territories, with the exception of Panama, where it stood its ground despite fierce pressure from guerrilla forces. Many researchers and contemporary historians maintain that, in fact, the Lat-Am Wars were responsible for the U.S.'s eventual collapse, breaking up the Gang of Four, CIA, FBI, DEA, and NSA, and decimating the U.S. Army. However, it's important to bear in mind that no external conflict could have toppled the colossus of American imperialism were it not already built on clay foundations. Protein Farms, a report. Protein Farms are currently the source of most meat and meat substitute products in Night City. Biotechnica is the clear industry leader, providing for over half of the city's demand for alternative protein. Currently, the most popular, albeit cost-intensive, form of production is based on protein-rich crickets, which allow producers to achieve the highest quality protein. Earthworms are available as a cheaper alternative, achieving a higher yield of product per square meter. Oh my god, square meters of earthworms. However, worms pose a more difficult marketing challenge. While crickets have become acceptable, most consumers still bristle at being told to go eat worms. I did pick up a few other things. Devillery. I'm just selling things here. Let me take a look at what we picked up during that firefight. Yokai. Japanese demons of yesterday and today. They make their homes on mountaintops, in rivers and oceans, on city streets, and on every mega building floor with the number 4 on it. In it. Even in your washing machine or infravisor. Why just with the number 4 in it? Some appear in concrete places, while others simply haunt a specific person. They're there when you hear a strange noise in the middle of the desert. They're there when you feel like someone's watching you, although there's not a soul in sight. They're there when you glimpse something out of the corner of your eye, something nobody else seems to notice, but you are just at the Ripper Docks for your checkup. The yokai first appear in Japanese subculture in the year 797. These mysterious beings, though closely linked to the invisible realm of the dead, have been alive in the Japanese consciousness from the very birth of animism. It's not that the Japanese believe in the yokai, they simply know the yokai exist. In addition to phantoms, ogres, and other mysterious phenomena, the yokai also include a group of shape-shifting demons called abake, or bakemono. The bakemono are said to sometimes take the form of a faceless person, a one-eyed scarecrow, or an animal. It's said that when a cat reaches a certain age, it becomes a bakeneko. These yokai are able to walk on their two hind legs, speak and dance, assume a human form, or even devour their owners and take their place. The bakeneko sometimes visit people in their sleep, or even wake the dead. All they have to do is hop over a corpse to bring it suddenly back to life. Oh my god. That's somehow terrifying yet awesome at the same time. Once a cat reaches a certain age, it could walk on its two hind legs, speak, dance, assume a human form, devour owners, take their place, and if they jump over a corpse, it comes back to life. I mean, as if cats weren't all powerful already. However, the demons are capable of much, much more. One should exercise extreme caution around a double-tailed cat. This is a nekomata, a yokai with shamanistic and necromantic capabilities, able to place curses on people and control the dead. In its human form, A nekomata resembles an old woman, often one addicted to some substance or another, with an eerie, disturbing air about her. However, let me assure American readers of this book today, the most likely place you'll find a Beke Neko is in the form of lucky Maneki Neko figurines. After all, real cats are an even rarer sight these days than your average yokai. Really? I pet a cat before. Back behind, what's his name? Victor Vector's place. Shop. In the Shade of an Apple Tree by Virginia Granchester. My first memory isn't an image or a sound, but a smell. The smell of rotting apples. Intense and dizzyingly sweet. I must have been around 4. We were spending the summer at my grandparents' house. They had a small orchard with this old, huge apple tree by the fence. That year it grew so many apples that nobody even bothered to pick them. We just watched them fall to the ground, where they lay rotting. It's hard to imagine now, a world where things used to grow out of the ground, without our help, without bioengineering, where an apple was something normal, a fruit whose shape and taste every child knew by instinct, where a normal person, like my granddad, could have more than he needed. Sometimes I think back to that orchard and that sweet, drowsy smell, but all I taste is bitterness. California After Dusk, The Life of Richard Knight. Richard Knight was a pessimist. Even in the late 80s, when the economy seemed headed for endless growth and the nuclear threat for the ash heap of history, Knight saw the United States as hurtling toward collapse. Richard Knight was an optimist. He deeply believed that the world could be changed for the better, and that he was the one to do it. Richard Knight was a realist. Aware that he couldn't change the face of the world all at once, he decided to start small, for him at least, by constructing the ideal city. His utopian metropolis was to be called Coronado City. It would stand as a metaphorical city on a hill, a shining example to the rest of the world. Richard Knight was doomed to fail, not because his vision was inherently impossible to realize, but because many important, powerful people wished to make it so. Richard Knight was murdered. The city whose foundations he laid was finished after his death, but his utopian dream soon became a dystopian nightmare. Even the original name was lost. In honor of the city's tragically deceased founder, Coronado City was rechristened Night City. Ironically, the name fits. If anything, the city is a cat, sleepy during the day. It comes frantically alive at night, and it loves to toy with its prey. Maybe you should call it Maki Neko City. The Flowers of Silence, a biography of Hanoko Arasaka. If I had written this biography on the basis of publicly available material, there would be 2 sides to this story, not to mention the foreword, afterword, and the acknowledgments. Everyone knows that Hanako Arasaka is a very private individual. Everyone has heard about the tragic death of the last reporter who attempted to pen her life story. 10 shots to the back. Suicide, according to the police. That's why, when my publisher asked me to write this book, I had to politely decline. Then, when I saw the advance they were offering me, I started to reconsider. And finally, when I discovered that Arasaka's PR department had given its stamp of approval to interview numerous members of Hanoko's entourage, I was on the next flight to Tokyo. Soon enough, however, I lost my original enthusiasm. The people Arasaka sent me to be interviewed repeated the same answers to all questions, clearly memorized by heart. After a month's worth of research, all I had was, Hanoko Arasaka is the daughter of Saburo Arasaka from his third wife, Michiko. She was born in 1999 in Tokyo and has only left the city 5 times in her life. Living a cloistered lifestyle, she never fulfilled any important role in the family business. She was very close to Yoronobu Arasaka, the black sheep in the family. I was ready to give up when, in the archives of a local TV station, I found a recording of the opening of an Arasaka branch in Fukuoka, graced by the presence of none other than Hanoko herself. She played the piano, Debussy's Reverie. Why that piece? Why play a dreamy, introspective song while surrounded by stoic Japanese businessmen? Her golden fingers caressed the keys. I was mesmerized. Tears rolled down my cheeks as I listened. That's when I knew I had to finish this book. I had to meet this enigmatic woman and find out who Hanoko Arasaka really was. And that's it. Okay. All right, we're going in. Did it work? The save thing flashes by so quick. The No-Tell Motel. That's right. So they would bring us here when if things went south. Yeah, Delamine. How you doing?
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I'm gathering this is a non-combat area, so... But why did it say I had to secure the area or something? Oh, I thought I could play this. That would be awesome. Roach Race? Such, like, epic music for this. I guess that's the name of the horse? Roach? I thought you're literally racing roaches. How am I supposed to get there? Oh, I go up. Oh! It's on this floor. Hi.
Hello.
How are you today? Yeah, I'm bummed about Jackie. I do. Avian Extermination Act? The AEA was adopted by the Night City Council on May 4th, 2063. Purpose, in the face of increasingly frequent and deadly zoonotic disease outbreaks, the City Council has decided that the most effective method for reducing the risk of infection among residents is via the extermination of all avian life within 18 miles of city limits. See Figure 1. Well, I can't see Figure 1. The extermination process will begin on May 7, 2063, once the call and selection of tenders for the contract have been completed. See Annex 2. Yeah, well, like chicken tenders. So that's the room. Shell casing keychain. So what's...
Ah, the nerve.
Wow. So what's through here? Can't open any of these things. Authorization not found. Oh, for body disposal. Well, I don't know if I need to be disposing any bodies. Hopefully not. I've had enough of fighting for right now. Oh, can't go that way. Alright, 204. Yo, it's me.
Let me.
He waiting.
Hustle? Are you the muscle named Hustle? Why do you say Hustle? It's Oleg Darkovich.
WNS, N54, even the pirate networks. You blowing up everywhere. And the Jackster, he out in the car?
Yeah, he's there. Dead.
Yeah, he's there. Dead.
Condolences, friend.
Thanks.
And the relic. Miss V?
Got it right here.
Got it right here.
I was afraid of that.
What?
Saburo Arasaka. Dead. You got any notion of the shit you pulled me into? You off the fucking Emperor! His Majesty!
I know I did not.
Anyone with so much as a pinky toe dipped in this mess is as good as dead!
I don't have a chance to tell him I did not kill the Emperor. We gotta leave town.
Hello?
Call Evelyn.
Gotta leave Night City.
You don't say.
Ring Evelyn. We close the deal, collect our cut, and drop off the radar.
Alright, settle down. Gotta be tactical about this. Parker, Eddie's. Then we leave the city limits behind. But first, your face got blood all over it.
Not surprised.
Bathroom's there. Go get yourself cleaned up. It's me.
It smashed the mirror. I might do that next. I didn't wash off my other hand. Leave the bathroom. Thought I might say something else in the other text.
Right.
Whoa! Ah! Yeah, I just washed my face of blood and now you're getting it bloody again.
Game risky, V. Remember our first combo? Seems I've chosen the quiet life after all.
How are you doing?
Dex,
no
what
blaze
the fuck?
Of glory for me.
Ugh. Welcome to Cyberpunk 2077.